My name is Matt Broderick. I'm a co-founder and creator of Freenote Cloth.
I design men's apparel with a nod to the past.
How did quality get into me? I mean, it's basically an obsession. From my previous work experience, we had to design product around hitting a specific price point. The problem with that is that to hit that price point, you have to remove all of the things that actually made the piece interesting. With Freenote, the great thing is it's like, how can we source or find the very best materials? Every input that we put into that piece, it's gonna be the nicest stuff that we can find. You know what, it's not like the button's gonna make the shirt. It's not like the thread that we use is gonna make the shirt. But when you put all these things together is really what, you know, what makes it. And I think that people appreciate those details. There's a store that we sell in up in Oakland. One of their mottos is own fewer, nicer things. That's basically what we, you know, that's what we offer. When I was younger, I used to go shopping for clothing. I'd go into the store and I'd look around and I'm like, man, I wish that they, like, I like this shirt, but I wish it was done another way. For me, I was always like, why don't I sit down and actually do it, make it the way that I want to. Design, it's an expression of you. It's really fun when you can design something. You take all these pieces, you put them together, and it doesn't always work out. But when everything comes together and works in harmony, it's, you know, you end up with a beautiful thing. I have two partners in this business. First one is my brother. The second one is David. My brother handles production and David does the sales side of the business.
Freenote is a direct result of all three of our personalities in one. We come in every single day knowing that it's up to us to make it successful. So there is no backstop. There is no backup plan. It is Freenote or bust.
The best thing of working at Freenote is taking my brother's ideas and actually getting the product produced. It's, you know, a special cool thing to take something my brother actually imagines, creates, designs, and turn it into something tangible. You know, ultimately, we're getting the product in here for, you know, one of our best friends, Dave, to sell. You know, it's a special scenario. It's unique. We've all had jobs in the past, and we all say to each other how much more efficient and how much harder we all work for each other.
When we started this brand, probably would have made a little more sense to be up in LA, which is closer to our manufacturing. But instead, we wanted to do it in our backyard, which is San Juan Capistrano. It's one of the best places for representation of California. You have a mission that we could throw a rock and hit right across the street. We also have the oldest continuously inhabited street called the Rios District, also behind us. We have the ranches just in our backyard, and we're 5 minutes from the beach.
Southern California is such a huge input in Freenote. It's such a unique place where we live and gives it energy, gives it vibe, the punk rockness in the brand, the rock and roll behind the brand. We feel like Southern California provides a place to tell that story. You gotta be able to be inspired and be authentic to what's around you.
Freenote as a brand, we pull from all of these different inputs, and if you look at our product and if we're doing our job right, then you'll see a little bit of San Juan Capistrano in every piece. So why denim? Denim's pretty much the backbone of our brand. We like to use denim made the old way. The reason why I do that is because just the construction, there was no, they were not skipping steps at that time. I feel like a lot of today, there's been a lot of steps either skipped or there's a cheaper way to do it. So we're kind of looking back at these pieces to find out, hey, the proper way to make it. All of the looms that make this denim are all from pre-1950s. They're a lot slower, they're clunkier, but they also give the denim a lot more texture and character. And that's why we like to use it. I think the difference between us and a lot of brands is that we're really on top of the production. We got a lot on the line when we have the fabric cut. That could be like $10,000-$15,000 of fabric rolled out, ready to go. And there could be one mistake here or there that could actually destroy it. In a company like us, that we're this small, it's like that could be devastating. The amount of hands-on and how involved we are with the design, the manufacturing, to the selling process, it's like, I think it's just out of necessity. I kind of equate it more to being a chef, where you gotta find all your ingredients, bring the threads together, the zippers, the fabrics. You really have to walk everything through all of the different steps. I think that's what helps us bring the quality that we do bring to our product.
You know, the hands-on aspect goes all the way to the end of actually packing our own boxes. So, you know, we take a lot of passion knowing that our end product to the end consumer, everybody's had a hand in it.
It's been such an honor to build this brand. It's been so much fun. It's been such a beautiful process of just creating something that you want to create. So much passion has been put into it, so much effort, time, sweat, tears. The challenge is just to keep that going. Like, failure is right around the corner, so is prosperity. If you stay vigilant and you stay focused and you remain patient, minimize mistakes, capitalize on the positives, if everything our parents taught us about hard work is true, then it should work out. And if not, they fucking lied to us, and that'd be a massive bummer.
For the long term, it's like I'd love to see this as just a business doing it their way. I'd love to have some more brick and mortar retail. And for us, I think it's just, you know, something sustainable and that we can hang on to, and who knows, maybe pass it down to our kids.